Chlorthalidone is a diuretic used to treat hypertension or edema caused by heart failure, renal failure, hepatic cirrhosis, estrogen therapy, and other conditions. In this video, let's find found. What is chlorthalidone? What is chlorthalidone used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking chlorthalidone? How does chlorthalidone work? How to use chlorthalidone? What is chlorthalidone? Chlorthalidone, also known as chlorthalidone, is a thiazide-like diuretic drug used to treat high blood pressure, swelling, diabetes insipidus, and renal tubular acidosis. Because chlorthalidone is reliably effective in most patients with high blood pressure, it is considered a preferred initial treatment. What is chlorthalidone used for? Chlorthalidone is indicated in the management of hypertension either as the sole therapeutic agent or to enhance the effect of other antihypertensive drugs in the more severe forms of hypertension. Chlorthalidone is indicated as adjunctive therapy in edema associated with congestive heart failure, hepatic cirrhosis, and corticosteroid and estrogen therapy. Chlorthalidone has also been found useful in edema due to various forms of renal dysfunction, such as nephrotic syndrome, acute glomerulonephritis, and chronic renal failure. Contraindication. Chlorthalidone is contraindicated for patients known to have hypersensitivity to chlorthalidone, hypersensitivity to the sulfonamides-derived medications, significant electrolyte derangement, severe hypokalemia, severe hyponatremia, anuria. Side effects. Common adverse effects include low blood potassium, low blood sodium, high blood sugar, dizziness, and erectile dysfunction. Other adverse effects may include gout, low blood magnesium, high blood calcium, allergic reactions, and low blood pressure. Some reviews have found chlorthalidone and hydrochlorothiazide to have a similar risk of adverse effects, while other reviews have found chlorthalidone to have a higher risk. Mechanism of action. Chlorthalidone prevents reabsorption of sodium and chloride through inhibition of the Na+/Cl symporter in the cortical diluting segment of the ascending limb of the loop of Henle. Reduction of sodium reabsorption subsequently reduces extracellular fluid and plasma volume via an osmotic sodium-driven diuresis. By increasing the delivery of sodium to the distal renal tubule, chlorthalidone indirectly increases potassium excretion via the sodium-potassium exchange mechanism. The exact mechanism of chlorthalidone's antihypertensive effect is under debate, however, it is thought that increased diuresis results in decreased plasma and extracellular fluid volume, which therefore requires decreased cardiac output and overall lowers blood pressure. Chlorthalidone has also been shown to decrease platelet aggregation and vascular permeability, as well as promote angiogenesis in vitro, which is thought to be partly the result of reductions in hepatic anhydrase-dependent pathways. These pathways may play a role in chlorthalidone's cardiovascular risk reduction effects. Half-life. 40 to 50 hours. Dose. Hypertension. December 5, 25 mg/day PO. May increase to 50 mg q day after a suitable trial, not to exceed 100 mg per day. Usual dose range is 12.5 to 25 mg/day. Edema. 50 to 100 mg/day PO or 100 mg PO every other day, not to exceed 200 mg per day. Heart failure. December 5, 25 mg/day PO. Not to exceed 100 mg per day. Safety advice. Advice and warnings for the use of chlorthalidone during pregnancy. FDA pregnancy category B, no proven risk in humans. That's all the information about chlorthalidone we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.